Yesterday we have started the transients, DC circuit transients. So in transients, we have discussed the behavior of the inductor and behavior of the capacitor. What are the transient elements?
LNC.
Inductor and capacitor. LNC. In inductor, what can be stored?
Magnetic energy.
Magnetic energy. What is the formula for magnetic energy? What is the formula for magnetic energy? Half Li square. What is the formula for electrical energy?
Half LC square. L.
Half CV square.
CV square.
Because in capacitor, electrical energy is stored. In inductor, magnetic energy is stored. Okay. And we have discussed the transient conditions yesterday. That is in inductor and capacitor. At T is equal to 0 plus and at T is equal to infinity. At T is equal to 1 minute. See, at T is equal to 0 plus inductor access. Open circuit or short circuit? Anyone?
Open.
Open circuit. Why it is open circuit?
Because current take long time to flow.
Because the inductor cannot accept sudden changes of current, because the current has to pass through number of turns in the coil. Inductor is nothing but the coil. In the coil, current has to transfer from one end to another end. While transferring the current from one end to another end, it will take some time. That's why at T is equal to, immediately when you close the switch, at T is equal to 0, inductor cannot accept sudden changes of current. Because we know the voltage across the inductor is L into dA by dt. Your current is varying with respect to time. VL is equal to L into di by dt. Derivative of the current with respect to time. Slowly the current will change. Di by dt means, di means change in the current. D means differential. That is the difference of the current. There is change in the current with respect to time. That's why immediately the current will not flow from one end to another end in the inductor. That's why it is taking some time to pass from one end to another end. That's why T is equal to 0, inductor acts as open circuit. At T is equal to infinity, what happens to inductor?
Short circuit.
Short circuit. Because the current is completely passed from point A to point B, that is from one end to another end in the inductor. So at T is equal to infinity, freely the current is flowing. This is the transient condition for the inductor. Now, when you come to the capacitor, at T is equal to 0, capacitor acts as
short circuit.
Short circuit. Capacitor will act as short circuit and capacitor begins to charge. Suppose if you are applying 100 volts DC voltage, capacitor will charge to 100 volts. Immediately, the capacitor will short circuit and capacitor begins to charge from one end to another end. So, at T is equal to infinity, capacitor is completely charged. Now capacitor will act as open circuit because there is no more to charge. Capacitor is completely charged to 100 volts. There is no more to charge the capacitance. Okay, see here. Suppose if you take the capacitor, if you apply 20 volts, DC is the voltage across the capacitor. Immediately the capacitor will act as short circuit. Now current begins to flow in the capacitor. At t is equal to 0 plus, capacitor acts short circuit and capacitor begins to charge. Now capacitor will charge to 20 volts. Once it is charging to 20 volts, this is 20 volts now. Now from minus to plus, plus 20, plus to minus, minus 20. 20 minus 20, there is no more to charge the capacitor. That's why t is equal to infinity. Otherwise, at t is equal to tc. Tc is called complete charging time. Tc is called complete charge. Once capacitor is completely charged, your capacitor acts as open circuit. Okay. And your current is zero. At t is equal to infinity or t is equal to tc, your capacitor is open circuit and your current is zero. Once capacitor is completely charged, you will act as open circuit. It will act as open circuit. These are the conditions yesterday we have discussed. Any doubt? Now I'll go to the syllabus. In your syllabus, you are having first one. Series RL circuit. Series RL circuit. Is it visible clearly?
No, sir.
Okay, 1 minute. I'm setting 1 minute. Now, is it visible?
The marker.
Marker is light, sir.
Okay.
Marker is light.
We'll see. We'll see this. Series RL circuit. So, I'm drawing the circuit for you.
RL and
series. 1 minute, I will take one more marker and I will come. I think it is blinking. 1 minute. Okay, we'll see. Series RL circuit. In series RL circuit, let us take, this is the switch. Yes. S is the switch. Okay. At t is equal to 0, I am closing this switch. And I am applying the voltage V. And I am, for RL series RL circuit, this is R and L. Here, resistance and inductance are in series or parallel?
Series.
So, for senior syllabus, you are having only series RL circuit. Transient series RL circuit. There is no parallel circuit. We will derive the derivation for the current here. Please note, write a note. For series RL circuit, derive the current expression. For series RL circuit, derive the current expression. For series RL circuit, derive the current expression I. Derive the current expression I. So at t is equal to 0, when you close this switch, your current flows from negative to positive like this. Your current flows from the battery, from negative to positive like this, and it flows through RL circuit. Okay, now I had determined the current equation. Our purpose in this is to determine the current transient equation. Transient current equation. I had to determine transient current equation. Okay. Now here, I'm writing the loop equation. So in the direction of current, I will take plus and minus. In the direction of current, I will take plus and minus. So from minus to plus, it is plus V. From plus to minus, minus. What is the voltage here?
V.
What is the voltage?
IR.
IR. That is I into R. What is the voltage in the inductance? Yesterday I have told three formulas. One is voltage across resistance, voltage across inductance, voltage across capacitance. What are those? Write down here. Yesterday I have told VR is equal to I into R. VL is equal to what is the voltage across inductance now?
L into di by dt.
See here, we'll write one more step. V minus VR from plus to minus minus VL. Sum of all the voltages in the loop is equal to 0. Sum of all the voltages in the loop is equal to 0. That is V minus I into R minus L into dA by dt is equal to 0. That is the voltage across the inductance. Okay. Minus L into dA by dt is equal to 0. Now, I will bring these terms to the right hand side. That is I into R plus L into dA by dt. That is equal to V. V is equal to, bring the terms to the right hand side or left hand side. V is equal to I into R plus L into dA by dt. Okay. Now in mathematics, you have studied the first order differential equation in first sem?
Yes.
Have you studied? Okay. In the first order differential equation, you have studied dy by dx. This equation you have studied, I think. Dy by dx plus ay is equal to k. Okay. What is the integrating factor for this?
Integral if a d.
E power integral of a dx. Not dy. Because y is the output. So that is e power A is constant. Integral of dx is? What is the integral of dx? X. Okay. Now, this thing you have said. Now, what is the solution for this? What is the solution for this equation? For this equation, what is the solution?
Into IF. Integral factor equal to.
1 minute. Y into integrating factor is equal to
integral k into I.
K into integrating factor
dx
plus
c.
Constant c. So this thing you have studied in mathematics. Now see here, I am applying the first. I had here what you have determined the solution. Solution for what you have determined?
Dy by dx.
For y. For y we are determining the solution. So in our equation, for what you have determined the solution? For current. Okay. Now, here dy by dx, coefficient is 1. Make this coefficient 1. Divide the entire equation with L.
L.
Dy by dt. L by L is 1. R by L. I am dividing the entire equation with L. I am making the coefficient of dy by dt 1. I am making the coefficient of dA by dt 1. Okay. Now here, let it be equation 1. This is the first order differential equation. Now what? Here, compare these two. dA by dt. In place of y, we are having I. In place of x, we are having t. See, in place of y, we are having I. Your A is R by L. Your K is V by L. Now this is of the form. Now integrating factor we are determining. Integrating factor is equal to e power integral of R by L into
dI
dt. See x here, we are taking x. DI by dt, we are taking dt here. Okay. R and L are constants. E power R by L. Integral of dt is
dt.
Now you are integrate. This is your integrating factor. Now I am determining the solution. See here, I into integrating factor that is equal to integral of your integrating factor is e power r by l into t. K value is V by L. Where is K? This is V by L. Your K value is V by L. Integrating factor is E power R by L into T. DT plus constant C. See the steps. If you are having doubt, you can ask me. Now see here. Your integrating factor is e power r by l into t. Now here, v and l are constants. voltage V and L are constants. Integral, what is the integral of e power r by L into t? I am doing the integration for e power r by l into t. Integrate e power r by l into t divided by r by l. Is it clear?
Sir.
Okay. Now see here, this l and l is going to be cancelled. Now this is I into e power r by l into t that is equal to v by r into e power r by l into t plus c. Now I want the current equation. Bring this term to the right hand side. That is I is equal to v by r into e power r by l into t e power minus r by l into t plus c into I am bringing the e power r by l into t to the right hand side. If you bring it to right hand side, it becomes e power minus r by l into t. Write down that steps. Now what is this value? R by L minus R by L?
Zero.
Zero. What is e power zero value?
One.
It is one. E power zero is one. That's why I'm writing V by R. So now in equation 2, we know V value, R value, L value. C is the constant. Now I had to determine the constant C in equation 2. So now I had to determine constant C in equation 2. Then you will get the current transient equation. So how to determine the constant C in equation 2?
Initial values.
Okay. We will apply the initial condition. See in your circuit, 1 minute, at t is equal to 0, I am closing the switch. What is the, how the, what is the behavior of the inductor at t is equal to 0?
Charges.
Open circuit. If it is open circuit, what is the current in this circuit?
Zero.
Zero. If inductor is open circuit, your current is zero in the circuit. So I am taking the initial condition. At t is equal to zero, your inductor acts as open circuit and your current is zero. Now I will substitute this initial condition in equation 2. Right on. Substitute initial condition in equation 2. Substitute initial condition in equation 2. Now I is 0. V by R plus C e power minus R by L. T is also 0. T is 0. E power 0 is 1. T is also 0. At t is equal to 0, I is equal to 0. Substitute that condition. We will get the constant value. C value. C is equal to minus V by R. Because we know V and R values. Now we have determined the constant C value. Now substitute equation 3 in 2. Right on. Substitute equation 3 in 2. Substitute equation 3 in 2. Substitute equation 3 into C value. This is your current transient equation. Transient current equation. This is your transient current equation. So in exam, we have to derive up to this. In exam, we have to derive up to equation 4. In mathematics also, you might have derived this RL circuit in previous semester. Have you derived?
No.
In applications, you might have derived. If you have not derived, no problem. At t is equal to 0, what I had told, what happens to current? At t is equal to 0, what is the current value?
Zero.
Okay. Now we'll verify that whether it is 0 or not. See here, substitute t is equal to 0 in equation 4. Substitute t is equal to 0. What is e power 0?
1.
Yes, sir.
Here 1 minus
1. 1 minus 1 is 0. Your current is 0. Now we'll write two conditions here. at t is equal to 0, your current is 0. This is the initial condition, what you have taken. Substitute t is equal to infinity. Substitute t is equal to infinity. In place of t, substitute infinity in equation 4. Substitute in place of t infinity. What is the value of e power minus infinity? What is the value of e power minus infinity? Is it 0? E power minus infinity is 0. E power minus infinity is 0. 1 minus 0 is 1. I is equal to V by R. I is equal to V by R. Now see in your circuit, at t is equal to infinity, inductor acts as short circuit. If it is short circuited, what is the value of I? If inductor is short circuited, what is the value of I? Infinity the inductor short circuit, our condition. I is equal to V by R. I is equal to V by R. See the same condition you got here. When you substitute t is equal to infinity, your inductor acts as short circuit. Once it is short circuited, your I is V by R. Your I is equal to V by R. Okay.